Vulcan, you hear me? Pull your finger out.
Huh? Yeah, I hear you. My head feels like a bomb went off of it.
Well, shake it off. We're still not at the end of this stinking swamp, and I'm not gonna carry you all the way to the village.
Anyway, how come Hawk isn't the one with me here? He's the lead scout. I always go with him.
Hawk is covering the back of the line. So this time, I'm the one who goes with you. You'll get over it.
Why do I get the feeling I'm under surveillance?
You think nobody noticed your little stunt at the temple? Damn right we're watching you. Now shut your trap and keep an eye on our perimeter, while I keep an eye on you.
And while the captain has a nice chat about me with the Red Scribes.
It'll be a lot easier to talk to those two-faced snakes without you hanging around. Don't worry about it. He'll tell you what you need to know. And if he doesn't tell you, then I will.
Thanks, Sarge.
Let's get moving before everybody catches up.
You lot are about as discreet as a herd of hunchbacks.
I thought that elves were supposed to have superior eyesight. Do we look like stiffs to you, dickhead?
Not yet.
But with an arrow sticking out of your throat, I'm certain that even a chatterbox like you could do a passable impression.
And you'd be the next one down.
Possibly. Perhaps I should aim for the largest target first.
Not if you want to keep both your balls.
What have we here? Buffalo in person. Well, that's a good sign.
What's going on here? Who's the scrag with the pointy ears?
Thanks for noticing. I try to keep them sharp. I am called Relmar. And I gather the red-faced fat belly with the filthy beard is none other than the famous Elric, leader of the Freeborn Blades.
They call me the Captain.
All the Freeborn Blades call you Captain Elric. I have no doubt that they do. As for me, I've never had much interest in titles or in military protocol. I judge people by their deeds.
And what are you doing down in the swamps, besides threatening honest mercenaries?
Looking for you. Well, I began by searching for the Red Scribes. Prince Arundel is wounded. We had to withdraw to Valvanor, where I learned that you were expected. I just wanted to make sure you found your way there.
This is not my first walk in the wilds, arsewipe. As you can see, I'm on the right path, and we've nearly reached our destination.
Captain, those creatures I told you about this morning are gathering nearby. They're probably getting ready to attack us.
Ah, well, those are called chrysalids. They wait until they have gathered enough numbers, and then they overwhelm you. And it would seem your little group is attracting a whole swarm to the village.
Well, we'll give them a welcome.
Actually, in spite of themselves, these creatures do an excellent job of keeping Deadwalker scouts away without raising any suspicions. If we allow them to gather here and then massacre them, I fear we'll be moving their territory a bit too close to Valvanor, which will lead to our being discovered sooner or later. I suggest we send one or two men back. This will keep them separated and occupied while the rest make it to the village. I'm ready to volunteer. If you fear I might try and slip away, I know the area well.
Sounds like a plan to me. Vulcan, you're on it.
I want to go too. The animals and plants in this swamp are extraordinary. And the venom of these chrysalids seems very interesting. I'd love to get a chance to observe them more closely.
Sybil, that is out of the question. Have you lost your mind? It's too dangerous.
Come on, let her off the leash. It'll be good for her. I promise I'll bring her back in one piece.
Vulcan, rule number two.
We'll see you at the village.
Sybil!
See you later. Sybil, can I talk to you?
Yes?
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
What do you want to know?
So Alas is your father?
Yes. And yes, he is the leader of the Red Scribes.
That's handy for you.
You are so predictable. Daddy's little girl can do whatever she wants, right? Don't fool yourself. I'm endlessly having to prove myself more than any other scribe. My father doesn't treat me better than the others, and I expect no less from him.
At least that explains why you look like you just stepped out of a library. I guess he encourages you?
Yes, of course. But I'm big enough to make my own choices. Knowledge fascinates me, and I suppose it would have been like that whoever my father was.
Can you tell me more about your order?
Of course. The Red Scribes are an order of sages. Our quest is to find the answers to all the great mysteries of this world.
And so you know about magic?
We study magic from an essentially theoretical viewpoint, but we're not an order of magicians. Even though some of us practice healing magic, but we have nothing to do with the destructive power magic used by the Lords of the Frozen Shadows, and we know very little about that domain, unfortunately.
I see. But that doesn't mean you can't research it, huh?
Obviously, especially now. Any knowledge which would help us turn this war around would be helpful. But according to our archives, we were already studying magic more than 5 centuries ago.
Oh, really? What do you know about the Ice Lords?
As much as it is possible to know without having met them. In some ways, they're quite fascinating, even though the term might seem inappropriate.
Perfect. How do we kill him?
If I knew that, do you think I would keep it to myself? But I can tell you this, we do believe it's possible. We know that there are 7 lords. Black Storm, Lady Crystal, Marshall Winters, the White Lady, Lord Blackfrost, the Chiller, and the Ice Duchess.
Everybody knows that. We've had our asses kicked by them enough.
For sure. But in the past, there were more of them. Some scrolls talk of 9 or 12, even of 30 lords. Of course it's confusing. And I doubt they would have freely given the information of how to kill one of them. But you can bet that some of them have died. We just have to discover how.
Where did they come from?
Most people believe that the lords appeared recently, at the beginning of the war. But I have found certain scrolls that lead me to believe they have been around more than 300 years. They are originally from a region far to the north of Verdiel. For a long time, they remained there. The beginning of their conquest is quite recent. We all think that the war started 10 years ago, but in fact, it is much longer, maybe even the last century. It took them a long time to escape from their region of origin. The Dwarf Kingdoms were in their way, and they put up a fight.
You had me going there for a moment. I'm sorry, but dwarves? Save it for the children.
But you're wrong. The dwarves did exist, but the Ice Lords exterminated them.
Right. And I bet they also massacred all those poor dragons and goblins.
You know that dragons and goblins don't exist. You're impossible.
Do they have any weaknesses that we could exploit?
Not that I know of. All of the Ice Lords are powerful sorcerers. They are far more powerful than all the other magicians. They have an unlimited army. If they have a weakness, it's not that.
But in spite of all of this, you think there is something?
I do. We often imagine the Ice Lords as a vast megalithic power. But that's not true. In fact, they desperately hunger for power. Just because they pooled their powers to create the Deadwalker army doesn't mean they like each other. Their balance of power is precarious. As soon as they are done with destroying Verdiel, they'll probably start killing each other.
Sure, but that doesn't help us much if we have to wait until they're done.
Perhaps there is a way to stir up the tensions between them. Even if for the moment, I can't think how.
Let's change the subject. Do you know what happened to me in the temple?
I'm still searching for an explanation. Something must have gone wrong during the ritual.
But what was the god's damn ritual supposed to do?
The Red Scribes have always had quite limited magical skills. I believe that the ritual was meant to increase their magical powers to try and find a way of combating the Ice Lords. But instead of channeling pure energy into each of the scribes, the ritual called forth a conscience that settled in you.
Your father called it a demon. How come I got stuck with it?
A demon? That reminds me of the old texts, but I couldn't say if that's what it is. You were standing right there, so that force flowed into you. It could have been my father, or any of us, I guess.
Well, that's just great. What do I do now?
I would dearly like to help you. But even though I have searched through all the texts I have here, I can find no reference to anything like this experience of yours, at least for now. But until we have found out more, you must try to fight against this thing. Do not allow it to get comfortable. We don't know what its intentions are or how powerful it is. It could be dangerous for you.
So then, any result from the study of all these creatures of the swamps?
Well, I'd really like to meet some of these creatures who live here. But for now...
What can you tell me about the World Heart?
Many of the people on Vertiel believe that the World Heart is just a myth. There are many different beliefs from one region to another, but most of them have more in common than not.
The World Heart is where life and prosperity are born. I've already heard that crap.
If we were to imagine Vertiel as a living being, the World Heart is exactly what it sounds like, the heart of the world. It's what keeps the world alive. It beats, and Vertiel lives from its energy. If you wish, I can try to learn more about it. Come back and see me in a few days.
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
What do you want to know?
We need to talk about your combat style.
What do you want me to do?
You can't just defend yourself. You've got to go out and hit those enemies.
I will do what I can, but it's not really my specialty. told me a lot about you.
Really? He's not normally the one to talk to. Did you torture him or something?
No, I mean, it wasn't a big deal. I just think he has a lot of respect.
Thank you.
right direction.
You for everything you did at the temple.
Well, same here, I think. What did you people do to me anyway? What is this power?
Your captain asked my father the same question. I have no idea what happened. I think. But we're going to lose everything. It's amazing we have no record of disaster.
I hear they call you Vulcan. Why is that?
Look, all us Freeborn Blades have a nickname. We leave the past behind, and whatever we were before doesn't matter in the company.
So what do you do now, then?
You know, I blow things up. Stuff like that. Sybil, can I talk to you?
Yes?
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
What do you want to know?
So then, any result from the study of all these creatures of the swamps?
I have discovered a few things about the small chrysalids. They are much faster, but it seems that they can only attack from close up, using their pinchers. I also noticed that the medium-sized chrysalids were slower than small ones. But they, however, can fire tiny projectiles. Vesicles have a power that depends on their growth. The biggest ones are the most dangerous. Up close, their attacks can be frenetic and extremely dangerous. They can also leap onto their prey.
Help him out before it goes bad for him.
Determination, the knight was in an awkward position. He thanks the mercenary for having assisted him in his task. If he can trust the rumors that he hears around the village, he has before him the one called Vulcan. He has the pleasure of welcoming the mercenary to the village.
And you are?
The knight is called Randvall, last survivor of the Order of the Ember Knights, and now protector of Valvinor, this village. The new arrival is most welcome, but the steward is waiting in the old village inn. This is Valvinor. It is not a beautiful place, but for the time being, seems to be unknown to the Deadwalker army. This village has known better days. Before the war, it was popular among the rich hunters who came to enjoy the ample game in the swamps. Today, the only visitors are refugees, who are sadly too numerous for the scant resources of the village. A small healing house provides comfort and succor to the injured. The knight is quite fond of Mirana, the healer who runs the place. Does the mercenary see the building opposite? It was once an inn, but it is now the residence of the steward, the man now in charge of the village.
This is a very large inn, considering the size of the village. There must have been many visitors before the war.
With any luck, we might get to sleep in a real bed tonight. How come you talk that way? Always in the third person.
The way people speak is different from one place to another, and I am from another place. The Knight's people are a warrior tribe from Algandar, and he is proud of them.
Where can I find the steward?
As the Knight said,
what does the steward want with me?
The captain has offered the services of the Freeborn Blades to the steward. Steward must have orders for the mercenary.
Shit. I'm gonna get stuck being this guy's errand boy.
Damn!
I knew I should have gone with the rest of the company. What can you tell me about this backwater town?
This village is a modest one, and its reserves are almost gone. Its only strength is its isolation in these swamps, but that is also its greatest weakness.
I already figured it was some kind of shithole.
That the refugees and the villagers must live together is difficult, and the situation is worsened by there not being enough food. The swamp offers protection against the Deadwalkers, but it also harbors many dangers. Its creatures often attack the village. When the knight and the elf are not there to defend the walls, the watch often leave them unguarded. Shameless.
I'm going.
Here we go. Another one of these hick refugees. There's nothing for you here.
Call me a hick one more time, and I'll be using your face as an anvil.
Let's all remain calm, shall we? Please forgive my error. With all this commotion and all the thankless tasks I find myself confronted with, I often find my attention to detail slips. So, what can I do for you?
I need more info about Valvanor.
And you have decided that I have a sympathetic face. It's the story of my life. Talent worthy of a king's ransom, but surrounded by cretins who only seek that which is free.
What can you tell me about the steward?
Oh, don't expect me to say anything bad about Berthof Chambriard. I'm not always in agreement with him, but I can see that he knows his business. And he keeps the village relatively safe.
What can you tell?
Oh, don't.
It's not often you see an elf blending in with other cultures. Are there many of you here in Valvanor?
To my knowledge, I was the only one. That is, until Prince Arundel and his acolyte arrived. Does that pose a problem for you?
Not at all.
Well, it does for me. His Majesty the Prince of Imbeciles is going to bring us nothing but trouble.
Do you know the woman who runs the healing house?
Oh, but of course. She's all one hears about lately. Everyone here will tell you that she's a courageous woman, fighting a noble battle. Everyone but me. The woman's insane. There are already far too many mouths to feed in this camp. Clearly, she's fully aware of this, yet she stubbornly insists on making things worse.
And the Red Scribes, know anything about them?
Oh, certainly. A boring bunch of fusspots, spreading science and preaching the good word while never suspecting that anyone might see through their little game.
Our game? Well, pray tell, give us the details. Please, give us the benefit of your extensive knowledge.
I don't pretend to know about all their little plots. I spend very little time with them, and frankly, I couldn't possibly care less about them. But I am fully aware that pretty speeches serve no better purpose than manipulating minds. They're nothing more than noisy masks behind which hides a reality that is far uglier. The more the melody is sweet, the better it distracts you. And is there anything more disgustingly melodious than the discourse of a red scribe?
When it comes to disgusting discourse, you seem to be something of an expert.
Let's talk about something else. Show me what you
have. Gold. So vulgar to work with. So wonderful to own.
Swamp is our best defense. Happily, the wildlife are just as keen on attacking the Deadwalkers as they are the villagers. But the situation here in Valvanor grows worse daily. And each new wave of refugees increases the risk of drawing unwanted attention to this jungle.
No Ice Lord scouts who find this village will ever escape to tell the tale. Of that, I can assure you. Also, my men are reinforcing your defenses. Forgive me for saying, but you have some serious weak points. Especially the defenses around that refugee camp of yours.
The arrival of the Freeborn Blades and the Red Scribes has greatly improved our chances of survival, Captain. Believe me when I say that we are most grateful to have you with us. Needless to say, your men and the Red Scribes are welcome and free to go where they will. But as for any other newcomers, our gates are closed. You must understand that our food stores are as limited as our abilities to defend our village. Until you arrived, we had but one person who was even vaguely capable of treating our injured. And the case of Prince Orendel was completely beyond her skills. And there is this beast story, doubtless another fairy tale, the fruit of an alcohol-addled brain. Nonetheless, several of the Watch have gone missing. Something hidden in these swamps is causing these disappearances, but we cannot risk sacrificing any more of the few men remaining to us on sending patrols. Large groups entail moving chrysalids that are unmanageable. The others quite simply do not return.
Silence!
If I were to listen to everyone, I would need 10 times the number of men I have to verify the truth of every tale.
Enough! You must aid me to do this. I am not able to do that. Your endless wailings are unbearable.
In the name of... Vulcan?
But by the gods, man, what is...
This world is condemned. The cold hath invaded its ground, its souls, and its heart. Yet here you stand, weaving your limbs like fish taken from the water. Miserably shuffling about to conserve the illusion of warmth and life, and not feel the passing of your last breath, while I must endure your wailings and lamentations. Pitiful.
Vulcan, stop this nonsense immediately.
It is not he who speaks.
All doth fall to ruin about you, yet you still bewail your loose bowels and vomitings. You cannot vanquish your dead walkers, no more than you can vanquish their necromancer masters. They draw their power from the very heart of the world. They drink it. They suckle it dry. Your only chance to cleanse what your own hath corrupted is to go to the world heart and liberate it from its servitude.
The world heart is a myth, a forgotten fairy tale, no more real than dragons or dwarves.
A myth. Continue hiding behind thy puny barricades, and thou wilt soon join thy myths and fairy tales.